Well, what's important to recognize is that when the CARES Act dollars came to the state, they were immediately they're allocated in a way that the federal government determined. And so that the CARES Act dollars were spread pretty evenly between districts. But as you and I know, different districts have different needs. And specifically because of the COVID crisis, because we're going to have experienced extreme learning loss, we know that those learning losses are going to be exponential in areas with greater poverty or greater issues regarding connectivity, issues regarding, you know, I was a principal in Wild Lake. I had a number of English language learners, all of those kind of specialized populations are the ones that are going to be struggling the most throughout this COVID crisis. And so the GEER dollars from the governor are able to be directed more specifically to those at-risk populations. So the CARES Act dollars kind of goes to everybody, but then this money also is about making sure that the populations that need a little extra, if it's to get technology, you know, connectivity to rural areas, if it's because you have a higher special education population in Flint, we have a higher special ed population because of the Flint water crisis. If you have a higher ELL population because you, you know, work in an immigrant community, those are the populations that we're making sure get a few extra dollars so that in mental health services. And also, this is really important, teacher education, because we've got amazing teachers in Michigan. I mean, amazing teachers, but they're trained to teach face-to-face in the classroom. And so taking those great lessons that that they're comfortable with and finding a way to put that in a format that's usable via technology, it's a whole different look and it's a whole different skill set. So it's really important that we're able to support teachers with additional training. And honestly, we have a number of teachers, like 20% of our teachers didn't even have connectivity at home. Their only technology was at work at school. So we have to make sure our teachers are connected first before we can connect our kids.